In today's video, I'll share 7 beginner and not so beginner home assistant mistakes that I've seen people are doing. I'll also suggest how to avoid them. So grab something to drink and let's dive right in. First, let's talk security. It's easy to get caught up in the excitement of home automation and overlook security measures. But be careful, your smart home contains sensitive data. In fact, it is possible all of your Amazon, Google, and Apple credentials to be in your home assistant if you have such integrations, especially custom ones. Not to mention your physical security, like smart locks, security sensors and cameras. You definitely don't want that falling into the wrong hands. To improve your home assistant security, I can suggest to enable two-form factor authentication from your username profile, to always use secrets.yaml file and to store all of your YAML passwords there and not to share this file with anyone, and to use secure remote connections like VPNs or Tor, as I'm describing in details in this video of mine. Next, we've got a classic error here that even seasoned users might overlook: forgetting to test your automations. It's easy to get caught up in setting the perfect automation and hitting that save button without a second thought. But here's the thing: complex automations can sometimes misfire. It's crucial to simulate different scenarios and ensure they work as intended before you let them loose in your smart home. To test the automation, use the embedded tools that Home Assistant offers. In the automation editor, run the actions and see if this is the end result that you want to achieve. Simulate the action trigger and check if the automation is actually triggered. And finally, use the traces options to get into the details and to debug your automation. After that, you can rest assured that your automation will actually start and will do exactly what you wanted to do. Here is a missed opportunity that can be also counted as a mistake. From my observations, this is very often, so don't let it sneak up on you. Namely, not leveraging device tracking. Home Assistant offers nifty ways to know who's home and who's not. We are not just talking for a convenience feature here. It's a security boost too. Imagine leaving your home vulnerable because you didn't set up device tracking properly. You have the needed security sensors, you have the cameras, you set a notification service, you even have a siren. But none of that is activated because you forgot to arm the alarm. If you just make an automation that will arm the alarm when nobody's home, you'll never get in this situation. One of the easiest ways to make this reality is to use your smartphone and to install Home Assistant companion app on it. That way, Home Assistant will know where you and your phone are at any given moment, and that will allow you to make a number of useful home automations easily. Dashboard or overview section is the heart and soul of the Home Assistant's user interface. Yet, many beginners settle for the default setup, missing out on the chance to create a personalized dashboard that suits their needs. Go on, edit that dashboard and explore the numerous cards that Home Assistant have embedded. If you need some additional tips and tricks, check this video of mine, but only after you finish watching this one, as I'm continue listing mistakes and missed opportunities that are common, such as not using add-ons. Add-ons are like little superpowers for your Home Assistant setup. Sadly, some users might not realize how these handy extensions can turbocharge their smart home ecosystem, from media servers to VPNs, terminals, MQTT brokers, Samba shares, and more. There is a world of add-ons waiting to enhance your setup. There is one big remark here: some Home Assistant installation types doesn't have add-on and add-on store. To find out more, please be invited to my webinar. I'll try to explain everything essential, and it is totally free. Now let's talk about a practice that should be as routine as your morning coffee: taking regular backups. Seriously guys, it's shocking how many of us forget or neglect this step. We assume nothing will go wrong, but life loves surprises. Backup and restores are your safety net. The more often you do them, the better. And if you store the backups on an external drive or cloud, this is the best. Embedded backups and restore functions that Home Assistant have will let you rewind the time to when everything was working like a charm, just before things went out of control. The best part, you can automate backups, ensuring you are always covered. I've got a dedicated video on how to automate backups locally or in the cloud. It's a game changer and the link can be found in the video description. Here is a little secret. The magic of open source projects like Home Assistant is constant evolution. But sometimes updates bring changes that can trip you up. That's where the release notes come in. They're your crystal ball into the future, warning you about any upcoming tweaks or potential hiccups. Take a few minutes to read those notes before you hit that update button. Believe me, it's a small investment that can save you a lot of headaches down the road. I should say that in the beginning, but if some of the words that I'm using are not so clear for you, not because of my perfect English, get my smart home glossary. It is all free and it is full of simple but useful smart home wisdom. Remember, the road to a smarter home is paved with learning curves, and I'm here to help you navigate them. If you've got any questions or ideas for the future videos, drop them in the comments below. I'm Kirill, thanks for tuning in, and keep those automations flawless and your smart home shining. Bye!